the National Chairperson of the U.S. Pinoys for Good Governance. Good morning.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Okay, you're calling for a global protest on May 11. First, I want to ask you, why call for the protests?
First of all, China has no right to be intruding in our territorial boundaries. Mm-hmm. And in the last 4 weeks, China has been very aggressive in this, what we call, what international body calls Scarborough Shoal, mm-hmm. or for us, since 1734, it was Baho de Masinloc. Mm-hmm. Masinloc is a town of Zambales, and so we have done effective jurisdiction over that since 1734,
right. mm-hmm.
and 1801 in our maps, and up to recent years, mm-hmm. where that area has always been ours. And then suddenly China says, bringing in their fishing boats, poaching endangered species on this area, and they say, that's ours, alis kayo dyan.
Mm-hmm.
We should be the one to say, alis ka dyan.
Basically, you're echoing what the government has been saying, that their justifications for saying that Baho de Masinloc or Scarborough Shoal is ours. But why call for the protests? The government has been continuously saying that they are looking for a diplomatic solution and that very, very careful of not stoking the fire, if you can say that. But your group is calling for protests. Why protests?
Yes, because the international nation, family of nations, should see that this big wannabe world power, China, is not following international law.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to be a world power, you must be the first one to follow the rule of law of the international body.
Mm-hmm.
They have violated UNCLOS, United Nations, Law of the Seas. They have violated Convention on International Trade for Endangered Species.
Mm-hmm.
And they have violated an international law regarding who has control over property or
mm-hmm.
over real estate.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so, you know, I want international opinion to sort of look at China and say, oi, why are you not doing what
mm-hmm.
you're supposed to do,
mm-hmm.
which is respect territorial rights of other nations, especially the Philippines.
Okay, the big event is going to be on May 11, and this is going to happen in different Chinese embassies in the different parts of the world. You were mentioning to me a while ago, off-cam, the different places where you plan to have protests. Can you tell us that now?
Yes, well, first here in the Manila,
mm-hmm.
it will be at the Trade Center of Senator Hill Puyat Avenue.
Okay.
Okay, at noontime. So, in the United States, it will be on the embassy in front, China Embassy in Washington, D.C.,
mm-hmm.
China Consulate in New York, Chicago, Houston, Los Angeles, and San Francisco.
Okay. Well.
And then in Canada, Toronto, and in Vancouver, and in Sydney, Australia.
Mm-hmm.
We're still negotiating or talking to our contacts in Rome, Italy, in Tokyo, Japan, in Hong Kong.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, in other places, there are very, very few Filipinos.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm calling on the global Filipinos who are concerned about this intrusion of China and who are singing the national anthem of the Philippines,
mm-hmm.
Sa Manlulupig, di ka pasisiil.
Mm-hmm.
All right, here we are, you know, Manlulupig. Okay, so let's stand up and show up on Friday, May 11.
Well, do you know how many people are going to be joining those protests on May 11?
Well, this is not the first time we protested in the United States.
Mm-hmm.
So they were from 50 to 150 to 250. But since this action...
250 per embassy.
Per city.
Per city,
right. Mm-hmm. Yes. But since this action is so overt on the part of China government, and you know, they're rattler saving, you know,
mm-hmm.
their military people are saying, okay, let's show them who we are, then I am calling on all Filipino who wants to defend the Philippines,
mm-hmm.
by just standing up and showing up in front of China Embassy, China Consulates, over all of this cities that I have mentioned, especially
mm-hmm.
here in the Philippines.
Mm-hmm. But what would be the ultimate goal? What do you want the Chinese government, how do you want the Chinese government to react when they see these protests happening in their embassies?
China should give itself and make itself open to the jurisdiction of the ITLOS, mm-hmm. International Tribunal of Law of the Sea. Mm-hmm. They signed the UNCLOS, that is the Convention of the Law of the Sea, together with the Philippines. And because there is a question on who owns all of this, especially mm-hmm. Scarborough Shoal, then they should just say, I don't want to join the court, mm-hmm. okay? Mm-hmm. Because you can only have a case in front of the ITLOS if the other country says, yes,
right.
I will be under their jurisdiction. Mm-hmm. And they already said, never. So this international clamor for them to be a good citizen mm-hmm. of international law, maybe they would change their mind. And if they don't change their mind, they stand pat, then they will be known as a bully. Mm-hmm. Okay, a big power over a small power mm-hmm. saying, that's mine.
Would you want them to be pressured, or would you want them to just listen to what we're saying?
Well, they're going to listen, definitely. But they're turning a deaf ear mm-hmm. because we already have requested them, you know, the Department of Foreign Affairs have already written a letter mm-hmm. that let's go under the international
right.
tribunal. And they said no, in no uncertain terms, and that's final. Mm-hmm. So, napaka, you know, it's out of, what do you call it? For me, the only name I can say is a bully. Mm-hmm. Okay? Mm-hmm. I'm strong. You want that? No. Okay. So mm-hmm. this is the purpose of our global protest.
Do you think that protests are going to be enough to make them listen?
Well, it depends, you know, on how the two forces in China, because there is one dove and one eagle.
That's
okay,
right.
They want war, mm-hmm. and another one saying negotiate.
Mm-hmm.
So by showing that Filipinos overseas, and eventually maybe the Vietnam people, Vietnamese in New York, Indonesian, Singaporean, you know, Taiwanese mm-hmm. will join us if necessary in front of the United Nations.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe international opinion may let them realize that they are not being a good citizen of the
mm-hmm.
world.
Mm-hmm. Okay, on May 11, the global protest
at noontime,
will there be any other protests planned after this day?
Right. After this, let us see. Okay, whether they are going to sit down with us in front of either negotiate,
mm-hmm.
but it seems that they have been always on a standstill, meaning impasse. So you need a third person. It's biblical.
Mm-hmm.
When two of you cannot agree, you call for a third person. And that's the ITLOS, International Tribunal of Law of the
mm-hmm.
Sea.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so China, if he is a good citizen of the world, should say, all right, let's call mm-hmm. in mediation from ITLOS, an international body.
Okay. Just a clarification, the U.S. Pinoys for Good Governance is not just focusing on having protests against China over there, as you call it, bullying. But you are also doing some activities for OFWs, if I'm not
yes,
mistaken.
Actually, thank you very much. We are helping OFW, Dondon Lanusa, who is under sentence of death
mm-hmm.
by beheading in Saudi Arabia.
Mm-hmm.
He's been in jail for 12 years. But it was a conviction, wrongful conviction, because he killed the other Saudi person on self-defense.
Right. And what activities have you planned?
And we
for
have
Dr.
been
Lanusa?
Raising funds.
Mm-hmm.
The Philippine government is putting up 450 rial, which is the money,
mm-hmm.
and we are trying to match that. Right now, we are 2 million short
mm-hmm.
of matching
mm-hmm.
the government.
Mm-hmm.
So hindi pa siya nakakalabas.
Right.
He's still in jail. And we, you know, it's one life that we can save. And people can do it by going to our website, www.helpdondon.com.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and if anyone wants to join the protests and also help out for Dondon,
yes.
You have phone numbers that we can give them?
Well, you can
go to... Or everything is on the website?
No, the website for the rally is www.uspgg.org.
Mm-hmm.
USPGG.org. So that's the information
mm-hmm.
for all our protests all over the globe,
mm-hmm.
especially United States, Canada, Australia.
Okay, Ms. Lloyd and Nicolas Lewis, a national chair of the U.S. Pinoys for Good Governance and former CEO of Beatrice Foods International. Thank you very much, ma'am, for taking time out to talk to us about your protests. Thank you. Okay. The Philippines has just been hailed as one of Asia's greatest street food cities. So today we ask you, what's your favorite street food and street food memory? Showing a discussion when we return. This is Morning Today at 6.